once you make a decision, the universe conspires to make it happen. Once you make a decision, the universe conspires to make it happen. Once we choose, make that commitment. That commitment. I will be this. I will see my world as such. This will happen. No matter what. No matter what. Once I make that commitment and know that it will happen, no matter what the evidence, no matter what my eyes may tell me, no matter what my well-intentioned friends may tell me, no matter what the books might tell me, no matter what the scientists might tell me, no matter what the astrologers might tell me, once I commit to a choice, once I know it will happen, it will happen. I see it as so, you know? It's like, you just know. I see it as so, I know. You know, there's no pressure anymore. There's no pressure. I see it as so. I know. I see good things. I see good. I see God. I keep telling you. I keep telling you. Just know. Know it to be so. No pressure. No doubt. You don't have to worry about, is it gonna happen? When is it gonna happen? Is it gonna happen? When is it gonna happen? You just know. You know that it is. You trust. Even if you can't see it with your eyes. Even if you can't see it with your eyes, see it with your heart. See it, believe it. It will be so, I know. You know, no pressure. I'm not worried about it anymore, you know? There comes a point when you get it, you know? That you know, you know? You get it, that you know? Who is this crazy man on your TV screen? You just know. So, this is the show? So, you say, this is the show? Yeah, because I'm telling you something that you need to know, and what you need to know is that you know. Once you know, then you'll know. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I'm trying to tell you what you know, and once you know, it will be so. No more pressure. Every dream that you've ever had, hiding in the light, hiding in the light, hiding in the light, Surrender. To stand in the light. To stand in the light. To be seen. With our flaws and our perfection. And to be beautiful. And to be beautiful. If you have a vision, if you have a wish, if you have a wish, I wish I had a magic lantern and I could rub it and a genie would come out. You know, this fat guy with a turban, he'd appear before me and he'd say, I grant you three wishes. What are your three wishes? And my first wish is that all my wishes come true. And my second wish is that I wish that your wishes come true. And my third wish is that all good wishes in the universe come true. And so I wish for this magic lantern and this genie to appear, this fat-bellied genie with a turban that we've all seen in mythology and everything. But you know what? You have that magic lantern, you know? You have that magic lantern. Your wishes, by having the wish, it will be so. I don't have a turban on. I might not have that big fat belly, but let me be your genie and grant you your wishes. They will be so. They will be so. It will be so, you know? That's all you need to know. If you know that it'll be so, then you don't have to worry about anything else. You don't really have to worry about all these instructions you get on the internet. All great stuff, you know, but you don't have to really worry about, like, am I visualizing it every day? Am I doing the right thing? Should I be meditating? Am I meditating the right way? Am I meditating enough? Not enough? Am I working hard enough? Do I know the right people? Do I have the right education? Am I young enough, old enough, strong enough, tall enough, pretty enough? You are all of those things, you know? You are beautiful. You are handsome. You are sexy. You are forever young. You're forever smart. You're forever, you know, just right. Just perfect. That's it. And, you know, once you know, once you know, you don't have to worry anymore. You can just let it be. You know, maybe you're just caught up in this whole thing about time. You know, time. You know, I have to get something accomplished in a certain amount of time. Like okay. When I was a teenager, I had this, I don't know where it was coming from, you know, if it was coming from ego, or if it was coming from wishes, or if it was coming from some kind of knowledge or faith, but I just had this belief that I'll be a millionaire by the time I'm 30. And a friend and I were talking about this the other day. And he said he had the same thing. And he became a millionaire by the time he was 30. And I didn't. And see, the thing is that what I came to understand is that all the things that I think did not happen or that I doubt may not happen, all the things that I think I do not have, a denial of the knowledge of the abundance of the universe, the goodness of God, the acknowledgement that there are no limitations, no limitations, none, no limitations. Whatever you think is impossible, whatever you think is impossible, whatever you think is only impossible because you think it's impossible. I no longer think that anything is impossible. Because I know that it's there. And going back to this thing about timelines and getting sucked into this idea that I need to be this by this time, by this age. Like when I was a teenager and I thought, oh, I'm going to be a millionaire by the time I'm 30. I had no idea of how. I had no reason to believe that. I didn't have wealthy parents. I didn't know people. Didn't have the right connections. I wasn't aware of any talents that I may or may not have. There was no reason why I should be a millionaire by the time I'm 30. And of course, with inflation, for you guys that are teenagers now, it might be more equivalent to like having $10 million by the time you're 30. But when I was a teenager, $1 million was a lot, you know? Nowadays, it seems like everybody has $1 million. But, yeah, I know, except for a lot of us, right? But really, you know what? You want to know something. $1 million, or even $1 billion, you know, it's just a number. It's accessible to all of us. And again, you know, if that's your thing, you know, if you want more money, if you want a lot of money, a real lot of money, millions, billions, if you know that you will have it, if you know that you do have it, that you've always had it, that it's always been yours, and you don't have to do anything, then it's yours. But again, you know, this idea of like a timeline, this timeline that is so, like, it's got birth and it has death. So I have to accomplish it by the end of my life, by the end of my teens or my 20s or my 30s or my 40s or 50s or 60s. By the end of the semester, by the end of the week, the end of the month, the end of the year. Sometimes this idea of time, while it's really awesome and really great and a great foundation and framework for our existence, it also limits us, you know? Because we think that if we don't have something in a certain amount of time, that we won't have it at all. And then we get into the whole thing, well, even if we get it, and then we die, which most of us seem to believe is going to happen, then, as they say, we can't take it with us. But if we can transcend the idea of time, of birth, and death, and realize that we can take it with us, but we really don't need to because it is with us forever and ever and ever. And you get to be you as long as you want to be you, unlimited by time, unlimited by life, death, birth. You get to be forever young. You get to be anyone you want to be, any modification of who you are, or someone else entirely, completely different. Once you get over these limitations, and you know something? The whole thing is that it's hard, it's really hard, difficult to see beyond the limitations that are defined with our minds, defined with our minds and our eyes. But we can always trust. You know that one thing that we know in our heart? God, or whatever you want to call it, whatever you want to see it, the source, our creator. That which seems to be beyond, not which is beyond, but seems to be beyond, because it's within, you know? God up there, God out there, God within. You and me. So even if we just trust, you know, trust. Have faith in the unlimited powers of God. Out there, up there, within. You want to know God? Feel the love, you know? Feel the love. The love that's in you. Love without limitation. Without need for acceptance or approval. You know, not love because you're trying to get love back. Just love without permission. Love yourself. Love the world. Love her, even if she doesn't seem to love you right now. Because she does love you. She always has, she always will. You know, that's the whole thing. This unrequited love, you know? How could it be that I could love someone and they don't love me back? Well, it just seems that way perhaps to you, but it's not true. That person that you're madly in love with, he, she loves you too. It loves you too. What you want wants you. What you want wants you. What do you think, God, you know, put you here to tease you with things that look really great but you can't have? I don't believe that. They're yours. But you just have to see it as so. Once you know, it will be so. You know, once you get over this thing of like having to wait, having to see it, you know? If you don't see it in someone else, if you don't see it in yourself, that's only because you don't see it. You can't see it. There are people, and I've said this before and I'll say it again, there are people who can lift off the ground and fly. There are people who can be in two or more places at once. There are people who can travel through time and space. Be anywhere, anything, with anyone, anytime, anywhere, and beyond, within. There are ghosts. There are flying saucers. There are space aliens. There is good. There is bad. There is evil. There is good. There is God. It's all there. Choose good. Choose dreams. Believe in your wishes. Now, I've said all this before. I don't believe any of this is new material. It's not new in all the Captyn Zodiak TV shows that I've done. It's not new for me, Captyn Zodiak. It's been said before by many others. Just articulated by different faces in different spaces. All that you know. We just say it for each other, you know? Sometimes I get really inspired and motivated when I hear it from Buddha or Jesus or Wayne Dyer or Alan Watts or Marianne Williamson or Louise Hay or Rumi or anyone. Anyone. You know, we say it for each other, so I'm saying it for you, I'm saying it for myself. Sometimes I need to hear myself say it just to remember, just a reminder. So, I hope that saying it over, maybe saying it in a slightly different way, at a slightly different time.
A is for awareness. The awareness of others that takes a man and makes him a human. B is for beauty, that obscure object of desire that begins where hunger ends. C is for consciousness, the consciousness of the world and of others that lights up the darkness so that no one is alone. D is for desires.
D is for desire.
E is for equality, that beautiful dream that will become a reality. F is for the eternal flame of freedom burning in each of our hearts.
Burning in our hearts with deep desire.
From the triumphs of the good, giving us hope and inspiration. K is for the certain knowledge that one day we will all live in peaceful understanding. L is for love.
L is for love.
L is for love.
K is for knowledge. G is for goodness. Hey, you know what's really cool? I just threw this the CD in the player. I never heard this track before. I just put it in there. I didn't know it was coming up. But it's really awesome, you know? It's like God just conspires to create this wonderful thing, because it's meant to be, and you know it's meant to be. If you're watching, if you're tuned in, then it was just meant to be. It was really privilege to be with you, as always. I'm really honored that in the last 25 minutes you've allowed me to be a part of your life. Share a little bit with you. My wish is that all good things are in your sight. In the sight of your heart, all good things. Just believe, trust, surrender, trust, believe, surrender, trust. Believe it to be so. See it as so. No matter what the evidence. Have a great evening, a great day, great week, great month, great year, great life. See you next time.